This episode of Victim Services Talk features Elaine Whitefeather, the Executive Director of A Community for Peace.
Community for Peace is a no-go shelter, so that's a little bit different than the come-and-go shelters. What that means is that when women come to Harmony House, which is the name of our shelter, there is an advocate with them 24/7, 7 days a week. So it doesn't mean that women can't come and go to their appointments and things they do. But because we have 24-hour supervision, we're a small shelter, we actually take the highest lethality cases that you can take here in the county, or we prefer to anyway. So we have some of the most complex situations, some of the most lethal situations. So women coming in with multiple fractures, multiple issues, their children are very much impacted. We get a lot of women who are coming out of gangs or trying to get out of gangs, who have been trafficked, etc. So we have some pretty intense cases that come through. So on the one hand, we've done a tremendous job in being able to provide services to victims, and I believe in eliminating the silence that kept us all trapped in it so long. I think we do a good job at education and awareness, but I think we have such a long ways to go. And the places where we need to work are really about all of us who work together, whose services intersect the same clientele. I think we need to work better and more effectively in collaborating with one another, in information sharing with one another, and not being so competitive. So that's the one area. But the other area I think we need to do is we need to address this multi-generational issue of domestic violence. The fact that it is a social illness and we're not really addressing the way the media is impacting this, our social networking is impacting this. We are at a second and third generation, so now victims actually don't self-identify as often as they used to. We have normalized the level of abuse, so by the time victims come in the door, the level of violence is so high. We have so many interdependent issues in our country, in our nation, and in our society that actually have its root cause in domestic violence. And until we all agree that that is the root cause of all of these other isms and things that happen as a result, we aren't going to change this issue. We have come a long way. We got a tremendous long way to go. I'm not going to see that in my lifetime. I don't know that we'll see it in yours. But I do know that if we can begin to make this paradigm shift and start working together as a coordinated response, we're going to do much better than each of us trying to do it by ourselves. The number one thing that we want all women, no matter what their decisions would be educated. Know what this is called. Know what its impact is on you and your child. Know what your options are. Know what are unhealthy and healthy coping strategies, and know when your timing is correct for things, right? And so to have us be available for a woman for as long as she needs us, 2-3 years if she needs that, allows her to have her rhythm, allows her to know she can do her work, leave, try it out, come back, and always have us there with her. So I would say that if our tagline is we change lives, and we do mean that. We mean that for everyone who comes to work here as an advocate, everyone who becomes our ally and partner. We want to change everything about the way we do business, the way we think about this issue. So if there's anything at all, I would say everybody at a Community for Peace is a change agent. We believe in it, and we know that it's more than possible, it's probable, and it's real, because we are the examples of that.